So this week we read the longest of all the Torah portions, 176 verses. What's of particular intrigue is the fact that at the very end of the portion, there is some 70 or so verses that talk about the sacrificial procedure brought by the individual heads of the particular tribes. And the Torah makes a deliberate point of repeating again and again in identical detail what each of the heads of the tribes brought. And it begs a question. Why not just simply tell us what the first head of the first particular tribe brought, and then tell us that the other 11 tribal heads brought the same thing? Why does it have to repeat the process again and again in all of its intricate detail by each individual tribe? And the answer to this comes to the core of something that is so fundamental in all of our personal lives. You know that expression, familiarity breeds contempt? That's the biggest nemesis in all of our lives. We get bored, we get restless, we're always looking to move on before even trying or, in fact, finishing what we started. How often do people claim to be trapped in dreary, mind-numbing professions, loveless relationships, or leading to simply monotonous lives? They feel trapped, they feel stifled, and they just simply coast through life lethargically without any sense of purpose. Even spiritually speaking, we put on tefillin every single day, we give charity regularly, we pray routinely. You know, the first time that a bar mitzvah boy puts on the straps of his tefillin, he does so with such fervor and excitement. The first time a young girl lights her Shabbat candle, there's so much excitement and passion in her eyes. Now fast forward 10, 15 years, is there still that same fervor? Is there still that same passion? Or are he and she effectively going through it as a quick, rushed matter of routine? Again, monotony kicks in, and we find ourselves merely going through the motions. So the idea of each tribe bringing its own sacrifice and repeating every single time with all of the intricate detail is in order to emphasize that notwithstanding the supposed repetitiveness, they were equally committed, equally focused, equally excited, and went about their individual tasks with the same fervor and passion. And by the way, if you think God gets bored from our mitzvot being done routinely and regularly every single day, if perhaps something is being done for the umpteenth time, that maybe it's not as meaningful or as valuable before him, well, the Torah comes along and tells us, yes, each of the tribes brought this sacrifice. These are the details repeated similarly again and again, because each was of equal value before God. Question is then this: how do we avoid preventing our relationships from waning? How do we avoid the monotony of the daily routine eating away at us and our spiritual aspirations from eroding? Well, it's kind of like that story about the baby camel standing with its mother and says, "Mom, why do we have such long eyelashes?" And mom says, "It's in order to prevent the sand in the desert from getting into our eyes." "Mom, why do we have split hooves?" "It's in order to prevent the sand getting trapped so we are able to trek better in the desert." "Mom, why do we have humps?" "Well, it's in order to be able to carry much water as we trek through the desert." So mom, to be sure, we have long eyelashes, humps, and split hooves in order to cope better in the desert. And mom says, "That's correct." And then the baby camel looks up to her mother and says, "Well then, what are we doing in the London Zoo?" You see, I suppose it all comes down to attitude. How do you perceive your life and that which you're doing? Do you see yourself in a desert, or do you see yourself in a zoo? The zoo can be exciting up to a point, but then you always remain confined to the same space. There's never an opportunity to expand, to grow, to discover new horizons, new sunsets, and in the process you feel caged. After a while, you simply want out. In the desert, you can walk, you can explore, you can build, you can transform. I mean, just look at the Nevada desert that became the fun capital of the world, Las Vegas. The seemingly endless prospects make each day novel and exciting. And so the contempt that familiarity breeds is only when you allow something to become stale. Only when you stop exploring the depths such that what you encounter every single day is not already familiar to you. Much like a treasure, every time you peel away another layer, you're going to find another precious stone, making the whole experience all the more worthwhile and very valuable. Shabbat Shalom.